Hello friends, so today in this video we will discuss the second problem from the latest Code Forces round 729, problem named plus and multiply. So you are given that you can form an infinite set of integers using this technique. So the following rules are: 1 should be in the set, and if x is in the set, then x into a and x plus b both are should be in the set. So it means that you can form that this is some sort of a sequence. So if 1, because 1 should always be in the set, so if 1 is in the set, then 3 will be in the set, because if any x is in the set, then x into a should be in the set. So if 1 is in the set initially, then 1 into 3, like a, which is like for any set, a and b are given. So a is equal to 3 and b equal to 6. So 1 into a should be in the set, which is 1 into 3, which is 3. So 3 should be in the set. And also 1 plus b, which is like 1 plus 6, which is like 7, should be in the set. Now if 3 is in the set, then 9 should be in the set, and 7 plus b, which is like 13, should be in the set, and so on. So you just have to determine that whether the set consists of n as an integer. Now, because it's a b problem, and also as you can see, like, it generally means that you have given some number n, and or like you are given some number 1, and you can either like keep on, like you can multiply this number with a or add some number b to it, such that you have to reach a number n. That's the whole problem. So like you can do this in a brute force way, because if you keep on multiplying a, then it eventually leaves a number or come down to a number which is like, if you keep on adding a, then it is like exponentially increasing the value of a, like the number x. So if you keep on exponentially increasing the value of a, then it can, like if you exponentially increasing the value, then the answer can be solved in this value, like in this way, because our like runtime is very slow, because the answer will be calculated in exponential time. Why at exponential time? Because at every time you are multiplying by a, so the number is exponentially increasing. So at one time it is like 3, the other time is 9, then like 27, and so on. So it keep on exponentially increasing the value. So what you can do in the simple terms is, okay, so one case can be, I can show you the simple way. The simple way can be, you can either multiply a or you can either add b's. Okay, so the simple, like the thing can be, you can keep on multiplying a and then you can do some particular b's. Okay, it will not happen like you will multiply some a and then some, as then add some b's and then some add some a's again, multiply them with a. So it's not that beneficial. So what you can do here is, so let's assume that you have some number which is like 1 in the start, then you keep on multiplying a into it, and then it will form the number, and then you can add some b to it. Okay, so the best, and then it can equal to n. So what you can easily see here is, if this number is there and then the other number, so what you can see in this problem is, so if it is 1 into a, some multiplications of a, you can calculate this in a for loop, using a for loop. So I can be equal to 1, and you keep on multiplying a into some number. Well, let's say the number is num. So you will keep on multiplying num a times. So you will first multiply num with a, then again a, and so on. So that you are keep on multiplying nums with a, and then you have to form the value n in the end. So if you have this number in the start, so let's assume this number is equal to capital N. So if N plus this value, which is like sum times X times B's, is equal to N. Okay, you have this N. So if N minus N, this number, is equal to X into B, which is like, this number should be a multiple of B. Multiple of B means that, like, this number should be divisible by B. Then only this condition can fulfill. I hope you get the point. So what you can simply do here is, I can show the code part now. If a is equal to 1, a means that the number of time we are multiplying. If a is equal to 1, then we do not actually multiply. Okay, so we do not multiply. So what we'll do, because a equal to 1, my simple case can be, because a equal to 1, so we just minus n minus 1. Okay, so if n minus 1 is a multiple of b, then the answer is yes, else the answer is no. Else for all other case, we will start with nums equal to 1. And we'll keep on doing a while loop till my total multiplication is less than, because see, it can happen that I keep on multiplying a, this value will exponentially increase and it can overshoot n, but I cannot go over n, because at max, it can happen that there is no B and all the numbers are only multiplication of A's. Okay, so what you can simply do in this problem is keep on multiplying num with A till it is less than equal to n. And what we'll do, because this is now capital N, like this is capital N, so n minus capital N, if it is a multiple of B, then the answer is yes. So if it's a multiple of B, then the answer is yes, the answer is no. So what we'll do, we'll keep on multiplying nums with A. Okay, and then in the end, if we do not hit a condition in which my nums, like this value, becomes like divisible by B, then the answer is no. Okay, so that's the whole logic. It's just a brute force way. And like the first A and B problems are a little bit easy only in the context. So try to think over them in a very simple way. Do not take it in a very hard way, and you can easily solve them out. I hope you understand the logic in the code part for this problem. If you have any doubts, you can mention on. I will see you next.